are you, Lord, our God? How sweet are your words to the taste, sweeter than honey to the mouth. How precious are your commands for our life, more than the finest gold in our hands. How marvelous is your will for the world. Unending is your love for the nation. Our voices shall speak of your promises, and our lips declare your praise forever and ever. Amen. Our first hymn is I, the Lord, the Sea and the Sky, and the words of that song are I, the Lord, the Sea and the Sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness light. Who will bear my light to them? Who shall I say? And we're just having the first and third. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Please repeat each line after me. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Father forgive you by the death of his Son, and strengthen you in to live in the power of the Spirit. Amen.
The words from today's psalm, which happens to be Psalm 17. Hear me, Lord, my King is just. Listen to my cry. Hear my prayer. It does not rise from deceitful lips. Let my vindication come from you. May your eyes see what is right. Though you probe my heart, though you examine me at night and test me, you will find that I have planned no evil. My mouth has not transgressed, though people tried to bribe me. I have kept myself from the ways of the violent, through what your lips have commanded. My steps have held to your heart. My feet have not stumbled. I call on you, my God, and you will answer me. Turn your ear to me and hear my prayer. Show me the wonders of your great love. You who save by your right hand, and those who take refuge in you from their foes. We'll now have a time of reflection on that. As Hilary plays as water to the thirsty. Hear the Gospel of our Lord, according to Matthew chapter 14, beginning at the 13th verse.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus feeds the 5,000. When Jesus heard what happened, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the towns. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and healed their sick. As evening approached, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place, and it is already getting late. Send the crowds away, so that they can go to the villages and buy themselves some food." Jesus replied, "They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat. We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, they answered. "Bring them here to me," he said. And he directed the people to sit down on the grass, taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish and looking up to heaven. He gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. They all ate and were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Lord, our Father, help us to hear your word with attention and understanding, and so to write its message in our hearts, that its power may be manifest in our lives, for the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. This morning, as every Sunday, we gather together as disciples of Christ, his closest friends like Peter and James and John, the ones he relied on to help him in his work of proclaiming God's kingdom. Now, I wonder if you have ever visited the city of York and been to the York Centre, where you sit in little carriages and are transported around back over 1,000 years to experience what it was like living in that city in Viking times. I wish I had those facilities here now to put you in, because I'm going to ask you to travel back with me 2,000 years ago. I want you to experience being one of Jesus' disciples then. You're gathered with him beside the Sea of Galilee. It's hot. The sun is beating down from a clear sky. Can you feel it? Look at the beauty of the waters of Galilee. They're a deep blue color, but the surface, rippled by the wind, orange of light, coloured reflections of the hills of dawn beyond. I know I've actually seen it. And here we are with Peter, Andrew, and James, and Philip, sitting on the dry grass, rather prickly. Can you feel it? And we're right next to Jesus. We're surrounded by lots and lots and lots of people, about 5,000, I should. They followed Jesus to hear what he has to say. But now it's the end of a long day, and those people are hungry, very hungry. Jesus suddenly stops Peter and speaks directly to us. "Come now, we must feed these people. They need food. They can't listen to me when they're hungry." What will this do to get organized? What resources do we have available? Looking at us. What about them? Philip replies immediately, "Lord, the situation is hopeless. We have nothing." Another of us, Andrew, however, is much more practical, and he said, "I'll go and look and see what I can find around me that might help us." And he goes off, while we mutter amongst ourselves about how useless we feel in this situation. After only a short while, Andrew returns, accompanied by a small boy. This lad has got his lunch with him. But he's been carrying it around with him all day in all that heat. You look at it, 2 lumps of bread and 5 little fishes. It's a bit sniffy. You think it won't be up to much. Nevertheless, the boy willingly offers it to Jesus. Jesus takes it and blesses it. And to our, and to everyone's astonishment, all 5,000 people all around us are fed. Every one of them. And not only that, there's some leftover. And Jesus asks us to go and collect it. It's hard work in the evening sun, but if you believe it, we gather up 12 baskets. Now I want you to leave the Galilean Lake side. 2,000 years ago, come back with me to this church, to here and now. With Christ's disciples gathered here now, today, listening to him. We, like Peter, James, and John, and the others, are actively involved in the work of God's kingdom today. That feeding story is told in all 4 Gospels, and it's so familiar that we may well forget to think about what it's saying to us, or we probably just switch. The story is important. It's not told to demonstrate that Jesus is some kind of miracle worker, performing wonders for the sake of it. Those hundreds of loaves were not produced out of a hat, or they didn't come tumbling down from heaven. That story is told to teach us that people can do amazing things if they make their resources available to all, exactly what they did, and link their resources with God's Spirit. Well, what did Jesus say to his disciples? Simply, what resources do you have? Think, organize them, offer them to me, and I will do the rest. And this is how astonishing things can happen in the ordinary affairs of today. All around us, figuratively, there are groups of 5,000 people hungry for some form of nourishment. Hungry physically, hungry spiritually. People in this village are lonely because of COVID lockdown. People all around us are now out of work because of COVID and wondering what on earth they are going to do. Further afield in our large city, some people are living in overcrowded accommodation. In the third world, millions are starving and have such poor health services that when COVID visits them, they will do nothing to help them. Everywhere today, people are traumatized, frustrated, so many have little hope, or their self-respect is lost. Christ speaks to us now. Come on, we must feed these people. We need to get organized. He asks us, what resources do you have available? What resources do you have to offer me to feed, to serve, and to help these people? We may well answer like Philip. Lord, the situation is absolutely hopeless. The task is too big. We feel inadequate. We have nothing to offer. And we give up. But this approach is very self-centered. Andrew was much more positive, and he looked outside himself. He said, I'll see what I can do, what I can muster, and then I will trust the Lord to do the rest. And off he went and looked around. And because he was looking, and because he was thinking, he did find something. And even though it did not look very promising in the face of the enormity of the problem, nevertheless, he brought it to Jesus and placed it as his, so that he was providing material for a miracle. That is a lesson to us. We can never know what possibilities we are releasing when we offer ourselves to God. Jesus needs what we can bring to him. May not be much, but he needs it. We may feel inadequate, believing that we have so little to bring. But that is no reason for failing to bring what we have. For we do have resources that can be used. There is our intelligence. There is our ingenuity. There is our time. There is our physical energy, our money, our material possessions. They are all the gifts and the talents that God has given us. If we use some of these together with our spiritual resources, prayer, and we offer them to God, we may well be surprised by what might happen. God needs what we can bring him. May not be much, but he needs it. It could be that the world is denied miracle after miracle because we will not bring him what we have. For his gifts to us, remember, a little is a lot in the hands of God. For his gifts to us are nothing without his help. We are nothing of ourselves. We can never engineer our own well-being simply through what we have. All the loaves and fishes we may possess, without Christ, we ourselves will stay hungry. Without Christ, our possessions remain simply five loaves and two fishes, which with time will become smelly and decompose. But offered to Christ and used together with him, they become miracles of life-giving sustenance both to ourselves and to others. And remember, the time will come when God will want to know how well we have used the resources he has given us. But all things come from him, and at our end, he will demand an account of our stewardship. What have you done with my food, my time, my work, my talents that I gave to you, to use? As his disciples, God needs us to offer ourselves and what we have, all our resources, to him for his use. We're called to work with him in order to continue his miracles on earth today, thereby carrying on his work of proclaiming his kingdom on earth and manifesting his love to the world. Amen. We're going to pray now. We come to God our Father, who blesses us in so many ways. We bring him our prayers for the world, for those in special need, and for ourselves. Father, we pray for your church, that it may seek to care for and feed the hungry in spirit. We ask for your blessing on this church, and guide us as we seek to find the ways to carry on your work in this place, in the strange, changed circumstances of this time. As we eat our meals this coming week, may we be reminded of your spiritual feeding, always available to us. Awaken in us our need. We pray that we may hunger for the food that only you can give us. And we ask you to fill our emptiness with your goodness and come to our weakness with your strength. so that we are empowered to be safe and effective disciples. Lord, in your mercy. Father, from the midst of our plenty, we pray for those who have less than enough in so many areas of life. We remember the starving peoples of the world, those who suffer from famine, drought, poverty, or whose lives are diminished through malnutrition and neglect. We pray for all who lack teachers and schools, books and education, those who lack proper housing and medical facilities, and all who are deprived of even food to improve the quality of their lives. We pray that all leaders and governments of the world will strive to ensure that their peoples have food to eat and the basic necessities. Mindful of your generosity to us, may we be generous to others. Give us openness of heart and mind to the needs of others, that we may seek to satisfy them with the compassion of your Son Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, Father, we remember with thanksgiving all those who have fed us in mind and body, all who have shown us compassion and tenderness, and care for us throughout our lives. We thank you for the blessings, spiritual and material, that you bestow upon us, and we give thanks for the people with whom we share. We ask you to bless our homes, our loved ones, our neighbours, and all who live in this village. Lord, in your mercy, Father, we pray for all who feel drained and empty, all who have no energy and strength. We pray for an end to the COVID-19 pandemic, for all affected in any way by it, their lives disrupted by illness, bereavement, loneliness, or loss of work. Inspire scientists researching a vaccine and a cure, that they may be successful. We pray for all those who are sick or dying, those who are nursed at home or in hospital, and for those who care for them, especially any known to us who remember in our hearts in a moment of silence. May all who suffer, all who are heavily laden, find your comfort, your healing, and your peace. We ask you to bless all our friends and all others who are on holiday at the moment, that they may be refreshed and recreated. We pray for ourselves, all of us here today, as we bring our needs to you. Bless our minds, our lips, our hands, and our lives. Lord, in your mercy, Father, we give thanks for all those who no longer hunger and thirst, because they now enjoy the eternal refreshment of your heavenly kingdom, especially Luke, Hutzonger, Lachlan's uncle, and David Spector, those near and dear to us. We pray for comfort for all who mourn, that they may know your presence with them in their time of sadness. May we trust in the hope of your promise of everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, Father, all that we are, we give to you. All that we hope for, we bring to you. Bless us, take us, transform us, and use us, so that we can effectively reveal your love to the world. We draw all our thoughts and prayers together by saying the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and build up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please feel free to turn around and wave to everyone, and peace to you all at home as well. We'll now enjoy one of those classic hymns played by Hillary. Guide me, O the great Redeemer. And the words of this hymn for the first verse are, guide me, O thou great Redeemer, pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Word of heaven, bread of heaven. Feed me now and evermore. To direct, sanctify, and govern both our hearts and bodies, in the ways of your laws and the works of your commandments, that through your most mighty protection, both here and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, our Saviour, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
There are just two notices, really. One is at the end, if you want to hear Hilary play, as so many of us do, we enjoy Hilary's music so much, just remain seated. But otherwise, if you want to leave the church, will you wait until the site people come and direct you to leave and be open to their instructions? This week, the Church of England has issued the diktat that as from next Sunday, everyone who enters church and is in church must wear a face mask. I don't think there are any more notices. Amazon. Peace stand to peace. May God the Father inspire you to offer the gifts he gives you, and God the Son help you to transform them through the power of the Holy Spirit, to nourish the needy people and situations in the world today. Blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you, wherever you are, in this church or at home, this day, and forevermore.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.